But for the grace of God, James Foley says he wouldn't be here to tell his story. He was on the front lines in Brega, Libya, with three other journalists when forces loyal to Gaddafi began shooting at them.
This was soldiers getting out of the trucks, walking towards you and shooting directly at you, you know, bullets streaming overhead.
Foley's friend, South African photographer Anton Hammerl, was hit and lay dying.
He said, help. He said, help. And I said, Anton, are you okay? He said, no. And more bullets came in, and I said, and I called out to him again, and there was no response. It's unreal, you know. Why him and not me? I was maybe 20 meters away from him. And, you know, he had a family, three kids, beloved photographer for many years in Johannesburg. And he wanted to do a two-week story on the Battle of Brega.
Foley, fellow American Claire Gillis, and a Spanish photographer, Manu Bravo, were taken by the Gaddafi troops and held in a cell, interrogated repeatedly as bombs fell around them in Tripoli.
Especially towards the end, we started to hear the bombs coming closer and more frequently.
He was allowed only 1 5-minute phone call back home, and he spoke to his mom.
First thing I said when I called, I'm sorry, Mom, yes, but also I'm strong. I feel okay, I feel good. I'm praying as much as I can. And she said, don't you feel us all praying for you? And you know, I took that back to the cell with me.
After 44 days, they were released and brought to this hotel where other Western journalists were staying, their ordeal finally over. Looking back, Foley now has a larger perspective on life.
I have to understand the grace that has happened, and you know, there's a reason for me to be here. You know, there's a reason all these people reached out, and what can I give? You know, what can I do from here on out?
I asked Foley if he plans to go back to Libya, and he said that he recognizes that he put his family through a lot of trauma, but at the same time, he says what's happening in North Africa is what he calls an amazing story, so he hopes to go back at some point. Lisa Sylvester, CNN, New York.